everyone. My name is Amy, and you're watching Life with Amy Now here on my YouTube channel. I am a licensed realtor that specializes in the Northern Virginia area, and if you like all things related to real estate, or you just like hanging out with me here on my channel, then I definitely want you to hit that subscribe button below so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. And as always, that's my little puppy dog, Gracie, back there snoring. I do have a little homage to her today. I'm drinking out of my special, can you see that? Let's see. It's a French bulldog holiday mug, so my little tribute to my puppy dog today. So cheers, everyone, and let's get into today's video. This is the last video in my video mini series, the who, what, where, when, why, and how of real estate. And in today's video, we are talking all about how to get started in real estate. I do get this question pretty often from a lot of you out there asking me how to get started in the business, asking, do I like being in the business? How business is going for me? So I wanted to sit down and have a chat so that hopefully I can answer some of your questions. And if you have any more questions, always feel free to drop me a comment below. Before you even get started on the process of getting a license, I would recommend that you reach out to one or two agents in your area. Choose great agents that will allow you to shadow them for a day or two so you can get an idea of how they spend their day in the real estate business. You'll quickly learn that real estate agents spend the majority of their waking hours working. We do get to set our own schedules, so we do have a lot of flexibility. But to be successful and to be a great agent, you have to spend a lot of your time connecting with people, helping your clients, doing lots and lots of research, and being on the phone talking to people. The real estate market is always changing, making it necessary for you to stay current with what's happening in your market right now all the time. That means always learning and always researching. Once you have done your research and you have spent some time with an agent and you know more about the day-to-day life of a real estate agent, it's important to consider one other factor, and that is how expensive it can be to run your real estate business. Just like starting up any other business, you have to put out money to make money. Once you're ready to get your license, you'll need to go to school first, so you have to do your research with that too. There are so many schools out there, and you just want to make sure you choose one that fits your needs and that is fully accredited. I personally went with the Mosley Real Estate School, and I thought it was fantastic, and this is not a paid promotion or advertisement for them, but hey, if anyone out there works for Mosley and you want to work with me, I'm in. So with Mosley, they do offer a lot of different options. And for the option I chose, I believe it was roughly $500, give or take a little bit there. I don't know if they have a in-person class right now with COVID. So definitely go online and check that if it's important to you. I have helped other people study for their exams. And if you need help with that, I would be happy to help you. Just send a comment below, reach out to me, and we can get in touch to set up some study sessions. You may hear a lot of agents tell you that you will learn nothing that you need to know for real estate, but I actually disagree with those agents, and here's why. In real estate school, you learn all about the laws and the ethics of real estate, which is something you need every single day in the real estate business. No, you're not gonna learn how to run a business or how to do your taxes, but there's business school for that, or work closely with another great agent or sign up with a company that will help you to get your business off the ground. Now that you've passed your exams, your fingerprinting and background check is all done, that will all get sent off to, well, here it's called DPOR, which is the Department of Professional and Occupation Regulation. And it can take them a few weeks to process your application and everything like that. So it's a good time to interview some different brokerages if you haven't already decided on which one you want to sign up with. This is actually a pretty big decision, and you can find tons of information online about all the different brokerages out there. You have like your big names, and then you have your smaller companies that are local, I'm sure. So it's really what works for you personally and what is a good fit for you and the type of business that you want to run. Once you find a brokerage that you want to work with and you receive your license, you then have to go and decide on which type of associations you want to join. I know here in Virginia, you have to be a part of an association to use the MLS system. If you want to have access to the MLS system, which is the multiple listing service and has all of the properties listed there, which is important in real estate, then you do have to be a member of at least one of the realtors' associations. And you better believe it comes with a hefty fee. I don't know the exact numbers, but I think with the MLS fees and the Realtors Association fees, I want to say I pay like maybe $1,500 a year for both of those. So that's access to the MLS and then also for my Realtors Association fees and dues. Agents do pay a lot of fees and expenses to get your business started. To run a successful business, you'll want to make sure you are spending your money wisely. If you want more information on a career in real estate, I would love to talk with you more one-on-one. Definitely leave me a comment below or reach out to me directly. I'd love to have a chat with you, give you my personal experiences, and help guide you on the right path that's going to fit your needs. And if you have something that you want me to talk about in one of my upcoming videos, then please leave that in the comments below too. Thanks for watching with me today. I really appreciate you spending time with me, and I will see you guys next time. Bye. Let's go now.